Hello, coffee drinkers. Today is very much an on the couch vlog. Appreciate your comments. Always appreciate your comments. Comments are awesome. You guys said some really super nice things. You guys also said basically that I kind of suck and you wish Chelsea was back in the vlog. Now, I don't disagree with you. That's the crazy thing. She's not back in today's vlog. Well, not yet anyway, unless she wants to make a guest appearance right now. She is. She is here. But maybe today she's a little camera shy. I don't know. We'll find out over the course of the next 15 minutes or so. I am talking about you, yeah. Just a little bit, a little bit. See, she's making an appearance off camera. And in yesterday's vlog, I talked about wanting to do this collaboration with Gabriel out in Texas. Kind of a Brazilian thing. And today I thought, okay, kind of got the changes. I'll just go in, I'll record them, I'll send him a thing. It'll be done before you know it. Yeah. Then I wrote some changes that I couldn't really play over. So today is really about learning the thing before I actually record it and send it over to Gabriel. And I've had it in the loop. I'll do it on camera for you guys. I've kind of got the chord progression down. Not gonna attempt to, you know, say all the chords as I play them because I'll probably butcher the loop, but this is what it sounds like. Pretty much there. And so it goes. I'm getting a little more familiar with the changes as I go, but they're still not something that fit like immediately under my fingers. And there's that descending thing. I talked about it a little bit yesterday. I still haven't had enough time to work on it. Where we're going, just major chords. Now we get into this other kind of run, suspension resolution, etc., etc., but it's really that. This thing that's given me a little bit of an issue, of course, the first thing to do is to slow it way down. I should just put that section of it. You guys happy now? I mean, I'm happy. This is great when she comes in. This is awesome whenever we see each other. But there were certain comments that said the vlog needed more Chelsea and less me. So it's been a lot of me already today. Okay, go.
I have nothing to say.
Okay, so just a little...
I have nothing to add.
A little cameo. A little just, cameo.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do what you're doing. You sound great, by the way.
Thanks.
Don't be so hard on yourself. Coffee drinkers.
What?
Don't be so hard on yourselves. Look at this guy.
So you do have something to say.
I always.
Come on. Yeah, see? Tell me, what's your thought?
I feel like the name of today's vlog is going to be How to Blow Over Hard Changes.
Okay. Wow, that's not a euphemism for anything, is it?
Wow. Okay, anyway. That's getting edited out.
So you feel like it's going to be the title of today's vlog. That's what I was thinking of calling it, was like playing over tough changes.
Yeah, that's a much better way to put it.
Okay, so, but you're saying you have a better idea.
No, I just think the first thing that happens when changes are really hard is you tell yourself you suck, which before he turned the camera on, I only heard him say about 50 times in 10 minutes that he sucks. So don't be so hard on yourselves. You're great. Just slow it down, put it in the looper, and you'll be fine.
Yeah, here we are, like, I don't know, 5.5, 10 minutes, whatever it is into the vlog, and I finally slowed it down and put it in the looper. Now it's at a bit of a playable tempo. Yeah, so Chelsea, she's always right. Not that I want to be right, or not that I'm pissed when I'm not right, but she's always right.
Only most of the time.
Still most of the time. So as per Chelsea's orders, slower. And now it's a kind of an odd number, but it's like 6 bars. Because this descending line happens 3 times before he goes to that 5 chord, that D7, going to the G minor. So I just have the 6 chords in there, and I'm gonna try and work on those. And our key centers are E to G, D to F, and C to E flat. So like I said yesterday, it's just, you know, moving, the root motion is moving in a half step, but the tonality is moving up a minor third and down a fourth. Yeah, exactly. So immediately the characteristic I notice the most is our first tonality is E, right? So if we just think about all of these chords and all of these tonalities in terms of a major scale, then it's going to G. So if I'm playing around with the E, going to G, I notice that I'm playing this major third, and then it's almost like I'm just dropping to the minor third on each one, because the minor third of E is the root of the next chord, which is G. So that might not be a bad, like, sequential place to start. Just to get familiar with where it's shifting and what my kind of key notes and connecting points of this set of chord changes are. Oh, and then of course it's a 6-bar phrase, so I have to remember that. Keep going back to the top. Process, if I did have 2 hours, would be to sit with this 6-bar loop and really work through it, go through like a sequence of rhythmic ideas, you know. Simple. Thank you. here. So I started off there with kind of one rhythmic idea, and then obviously it expanded and became a little more rhythmically dense and a little more rhythmically and harmonically complex. But that's my process. Of course, it's quite accelerated because I've been doing this for a long time, but if you're ever stuck on playing over changes, it's great to get in with a simple rhythmic idea. If you can pick out two notes that fit over each chord, they don't necessarily have to be the same notes, although that is a thing sometimes. If you have five chords, there can be one or two notes that fit over all five chords. But seeing as we're dealing with just major tonalities here, maybe just pick out the third and the root, or the third and the fifth for each chord, and go find them. Just work your way into the music slowly and get your hooks, get your key points, get your reference points, and then that's gonna just expand and allow you to play your natural vocabulary. So accelerating this process even more, I will get back to the loop at tempo and see if I can get it. Now, obviously, these are just six chords that happen in the middle of a bigger, much bigger chord sequence. So let's see if I can work those into the bigger picture. Pretty loose here, and I could go on like that and get lost for about another, I don't know, 2-3 hours or so. And but it's working. Like, the process worked. It's definitely, I accelerated it today for the purpose of the vlog and for making an example of it. But that's definitely kind of my path to getting through these changes and to understanding them a little better. And it's great to create exercises like that. Erdnaz started off as kind of a chordal improvisational exercise. Time Stands Still from Mystery to Me, this wow, that was a real struggle to Chelsea's, like, whoa, he's playing that? Is he gonna make it to the end? I'll give myself like a 6 out of 10 on the melody of that. But the changes are pretty tough on on Time Stands Still. Can I even remember what the changes are? No, is the quick answer to that. They kind of move around the instrument a lot and move through different tonalities. So a lot of these things, just like the way John Coltrane wrote Giant Steps and Countdown and those kind of tunes, 26-2, as exercises, they ended up becoming iconic songs that we all work on. You know, I think that was a big part of his practice, was just coming up with changes. And obviously the Coltrane altered like substitutions for 2-5-1s. That's what Giant Steps and Countdown are kind of based on. Great to come up with little ideas like that. Things that push you, things that challenge you. It's not just a blues, or it's not just a bunch of 2-5-1s. It's something a little out of the ordinary. I highly recommend recommend experimenting with that. That is one of the reasons I put all of those ideas in the new chord book. And here I am, like literally going over that idea. Really for the first time the last couple of days, play it from a melodic standpoint, from an improvisational standpoint. So as much as I've been playing that, it's obviously never too late to use it in a different way, and it's never too late to start creating those kind of chord exercises for yourself and turning them into real kind of, you know, fundamental elements of your practice routine. So, deep breath, dinner time for us. I don't know what time of the day it is for you guys. I'm always fascinated by when you guys are watching a vlog, and if it's with coffee or pizza or wherever you're at in your day. Have a good day. Happy practicing. Today's vlog is done, and I am possibly Chelsea. We'll see you tomorrow.